Yo, welcome. What is happening? Okay, rolling 40s here for you. I've been waiting to jump into this, so I was like, God, I gotta get on there and drop some bit, you know. Let's go insane-o mode, and let's get some TOA hard mode knocked out, okay? For starters, I'm gonna be utilizing this team right here. I guess I was already using this team, but I'm continuing to use this team based on I like the fundamentals and I like what they each bring to the table. I got Beretta in here. He's a nice speed leader. He has dots. He has this move right here that can set a bar back all the way. And plus, he's on Despair Rune, so we get plenty of stuns. Yes, I know I need to level him up, but I'm not feeding him any double mods, okay? Alright. Next up, we got good old Varimos. Varimos has been with me for a long time. This move right here is just primed. Plus, his passive is just OP, and then he leaves dots with this move right here, which is nice, okay? It's nice. I got Basalt in there. You know, Basalt's on that good Nemesis. So you see, I'm trying to stack his HP a little bit. We have Provoke with this move, which is really, really nice. I can decrease attack bars with this one, which is really, really nice. Then I got a defense buff slash a sip of heals, okay? I have Selena in there. Now, she's going to be in there as she does all sorts of harmful effects. Plus, she can do some damage, which is always nice, especially for TOA hard. This move right here, Blooming Nightmare. Oh, you guys all know if you've seen the last video. Blooming Nightmare is a nightmare, okay? It will leave all sorts of dots, okay? Multiple three-turn dots, okay? Multiples, okay? This move right here can disturb the enemy's HP, so no healing, okay? Top, 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 no healing. And this move right here, not only will it put them to sleep, but it can also, okay? It can also increase her attack bar if she puts them to sleep. 50% attack bar increase. Okay, so she's always moving, constantly, okay? And we all know what Varag can do. I gotta get my boy set of some will runes. This is just craziness. Absolute zero, freezing them and decreasing their attack bar all the way down to zero, to nothing, okay? To nothing. Secondary freeze move. If you survive the first one and I need you frozen, I can always freeze him with this. And then he's on Despair, so I can always stun him with other things, okay? That's the squad I'm rolling with. I like that. I like the fact that we're rolling with that and whatever. Okay. Anyway, happy Sunday. Okay, happy Sunday. Yeah, it's gonna be a good week. I can feel it. Okay. I don't have to work all the way up in the mountains. Okay, so I'm excited about that. All right. Already with a freeze. Now, if things start getting kind of complicated, then I will Pat Riley it. What I mean by Pat Riley, that means I'm gonna be doing the button pushing, okay? I'm gonna be the one in control. But if they can take care of things as like this right here, oh, Blooming Nightmare. Just look at all those dots. Just beautiful. If they ever take a turn, they lose like what, 6,000-7,000 HP? Probably a little bit more, who knows? So many dots out there, it's insane-o. And then the stuns are just, ugh, outrageous. So, when we beat this, I believe we get two mystical scrolls. Mind you, in my guild right now, we are doing a no summon October, which kind of sucks for me because my birthday is on the 29th. I won't get to summon, like, I don't know if you guys watched my summon session from last year's birthday, but I summoned a Nat 5 on my birthday. That's when I got Retesh, okay? So, this year, we know in advance that I won't be summoning no Nat 5 on my birthday because I won't even be able to summon on my birthday. Oh, sacrifices I make for my guild, okay? Sacrifices. Anywho, so, November 1st, we will be summoning, Wait, let me think here. November 1st should be... I don't know. We'll get into the... I'll get the details for it or whatnot, okay? Wow, look at this squad go. That's how I want them to move at all times, okay? Nice provokes and stuff like that. But yeah, so no summoning at all. We got a Guilty who did summon. He ended up getting a Nat 5, the Wind Fairy King. Which, that's not bad and all, but still. Hey, we're not summoning. If I can't summon, can't nobody summon, okay? So I will be showing throughout vids throughout the month, I will be showing my current status, okay, of where I'm at on scrolls to show you guys that we will be doing a very big one. Oh, that was Pierre telling me about the they gave me this rune. It was a legendary 4-star rune, a rage rune. Mind you, this rune had crit damage, crit rate, speed, HP percent. It had everything on it, but it was 4-star, okay? It was 4-star. There was nothing I can do with that rune. Hey, how the heck did they do that? They killed Selena. It's alright, this match is over anyway. Yeah, so this rune was OP, but it was a 4-star rune. It was pretty sad. I was just like, wow. You can't give me no rage runes out of this good old Necro, but you can give me a 4-star one, huh? Alright, we're gonna run with the same squad. We're gonna keep those dots ticking, the stuns and stuff like that, okay? Beretta might catch a little flack in here, but I believe he's alright. So Roland 40s is here, okay? Roland 40s is here. I know some of you may have gotten stuck somewhere in the 40s. I'm here to provide, and I am going to pioneer the way, okay? I need that Devilmon. That's what I need. We can't let a Devilmon go unscathed in TOA. We can't allow it. Alright, keep them dots rolling. Speaking of Randy, if you use Randy inside of the Dark Beast dungeon at the Rift, oh man. I had mine. He did a chain fire. No exaggerations. He chain fired for like 20 hits. I don't know. There might have been violent procs in there as well, but he was ignoring defense the whole way. Like 18k a pop. He was just like... Randy was on fire, okay? He was on fire. Got me my biggest... He helped achieve my biggest score in the Dark Beast, okay? I was wowed. And it just so happened my brother had come by, and I was showing him the Dark Dungeon, because he was talking about how hard the Wind Dungeon was. He said, the Wind Dungeon's the hardest dungeon. I said, no. The Dark Dungeon is the hardest, buddy. The Dark and the Light Dungeons are the hardest dungeons. Mainly the Dark one. And I showed him the Dark one, and that's when Randy was just popping off. And I was just like, wow, look at the Mons making me proud, huh? So Selena shouldn't have any issue in here, but it seems like Basalt is catching a lot of flack. Hopefully it can keep some. All right, we're going to have to Pat Riley this. Hang on. Hang on just a second, because our Basalt is catching lots of damage here. Nice. Let's try to sleep her. Nice. That works. All right, let's get a proper heal going on here. I don't want to. Let's just do that. Yeah. We're going to save that move. And let's see. Let's do that. Alright. Decrease bars. There we go. And now we shall freeze. Blooming Nightmare. Stack me on extra dot, maybe. Go with another heal and get. I gotta get my Basalt back up there. He's almost dead here, okay? We can't allow that. Alright, let's go with this, even though we don't need it. Let's try to get some dots. Here we go. That worked out just fine. So we'll provoke. Freeze. Dots. Sleep. Oh. You don't want to go to sleep, huh? Provoke. Stun. Do something. We'll take this bar. Okay. Sleep. Oh, avoided another sleep. Alright. They should be alright from here. So now we'll stick it back on auto. Sometimes the AI uses the wrong abilities, okay? During the wrong times, and it can actually cost me. We're not here to be doing unnecessary rounds over and over and over and over and over and over. Ooh, whoa. Lots of blinding light. I actually got the light bounty hunter out of a light dark scroll before. But I don't think I kept him. But he is good though, he is good. Each monster should usually have several different types of uses that they are able to do. Several different things that I actually enjoy. Uh-oh, Selena might be in trouble. Blooming Nightmare! Keep those dots rolling. Yeah, someone left a comment. He said, you're the only one that uses Selena. But he said he thinks it's cool, though. So I think I might have said, hey, yeah, like, several people? No? I'm the only one that uses her, huh? Yeah. Well, she was my very first 6-star. Wait, was she? Yeah, she was. Wait. Yep, she was. She was my first 6-star, then it was Light Fairy Queen, and then it was Kung Fu Girl. I have lots of 6-stars now. I don't even know how many I have, but I know I have a lot of 6-stars. Come on, that Blooming Nightmare could have did a little bit better than that. I know he did not use that OP move on that one almost dead mon. Beretta, uh-oh. Okay, there we go. Oh, nice Blooming Nightmare. You see those dots? Those are the type of dots I want to see. Nice stun action and everything. Look at Basalt just saving the day, okay? Oh, yeah, they're dead. There's just too many dots to survive. Not even a Varimos could save them from this. They would need like a Vela Jewel to kind of do a sanctuary type of thing for some sort of purification. Oh, man. He is catching it. Alright, on our way to 44. Marshall Cats. Now, with fire being in there, I'm kind of thinking of going with more water. Or possibly some extra fire. What do we got going on here? Thinking some OG action, yeah. She leaves dots. She does stuns. She even puts enemies to sleep. We found a winner. Alright, definitely bring a Varimos for 44, okay? Because the JoJo's don't play. Let's get these Marshall Cats out of the way. Nice dots from Rika. Freezing action. That's how I want Marshall Katz dealt with at all times. Frozen, stunned, dotted up, slow down effect, everything. I don't even remember any of those Marshall Katz even getting a turn. That was brilliant. Alright, ooh. Some water. Some predictive future. Does she just do... Oh, she does got a bomb. Wait. Yes, yeah, she does have a bomb. Ooh. But she doesn't have a Ciara move, so... We're gonna put Selena back in there. And... Yeah, we're gonna run with that. I am scared to see who is at TOA level 50 on here. It's gonna be quite the dogfight. Lots of dots. Show them imps who's boss, Selena. Yep, you can wake up from the sleep, that's fine. She's gaining attack bar tremendously. Blooming nightmare. Oh, I like those dots. Take that turn and take that damage. So we're doing damage on our turns, and we're doing damage on their turns as well. That's a win-win situation, okay? Win-win. Why would you do that? Why would you do an absolute zero and that thing's like defenseless? Well, they're keeping the Dark Oracle from moving, even though she just got buffed. Oh, she's stunned. This is primed territory right here for Selena to get down. Oh, blooming nightmare. Can we get another? All right, everyone's gunning for Beretta, so we have to be prepared for his funeral. It should be coming up shortly here. Oh no, they're doing pretty good. Dang. What is this, like the fourth Nat 5 I even popped in this chat? Well, grats. Yeah, it's over for you, lady. You see all them dots? I don't even think she can even get any more harmful effects anymore. She's like maxed out. If you have the light, I forgot her name, the light rock Sasha, she can actually extend each buff, I believe, up to like 7 turns. It's It's disgusting. Alright, so we got some Tyromes in here. I'd like to come with some sort of immunity to save us from that. My fire brownie is not yet ready. I'm thinking of going Vella Jewel, and then we will put Varimosa's leader. Yeah, because the sanctuary cleanses from all of that stuff. Because I was going to say I can either use that or I could use Lisa, but Lisa's more damage dealer prone type, you know. Vella Jewel, he's fast. He's at 2-something violent. He's violent, okay? He's very violent. He's going to get those sanctuaries up all the time. Alright, watch that ninja on the left. Hey, I said watch the ninja on the left. I knew he was going to take a turn. Wow, they are avoiding stunts like crazy, huh? Man, we can't put them to sleep or nothing. And why aren't there hardly any dots? Don't make me bring a bomb squad in here and show you guys who's boss. There we go. Oh man. Oh god. Too many liches. We need Blooming Nightmare. Stat. Okay, why did I bring Vella Jewel in here again? I'm trying to remember. I don't know. I forgot why I brought Vella Jewel in here, but apparently I needed him in here. My major judgment called for him to be here, so that's fine. And he lands dots as well. What is that? Absolute Punishment? What was that move? I forgot that move. Yeah, it was rough. All last week I had to work. Where I had to work was it's 115 miles away from where I live. So I'd have to wake up at like 4:00 in the morning, and it takes about 2 hours, close to 2 hours to get there, and that's doing my type of speed limit. Yeah, and then I'm there for like 12-13 hours, you know, straight through, and like there's no oh, we get off early type of thing. It's like we get off when the quota for what we're trying to do for the job for that day is done, okay? And then it would take 2 hours to drive back, and it was just a rough week. Some days I was doing like 13, 14 hours. Some days was just, I think I got like one day that was just 10 hours. All the rest of the days was like 11 plus. So that's why I haven't been able to drop any vids. Like on some days I didn't even I barely even got to play the game itself, okay? Oh, that's why I brung him in there, because I didn't want to get reverse frozen. Ah, you don't say. Well, I take Tyrone seriously, that's probably why. Okay. I know my Tyrone will freeze you, and then he will proc spirit throw and destroy you, so I took Come to Us as Tyrone very seriously. Same way, just like I would in Arena. Like, I don't play around with Tyrone, because once you get frozen, you're kind of helpless until you get out of that freeze. Like, that monster doesn't even get a turn, and it's nasty. So they're doing 2,800 per dot now, so you know that the HP increase is already there, which is always nice. Yeah, 28 and some change per dot. And he's just trying to just take stuff to the face like a champ, too. Go to sleep. Yep. Ooh, Ghoulamane and the light guy. Nice. I'm thinking we can go this. Now that's a sniper. I would like to. Actually, let's leave him as leader. I'd like to bring Lexi for this one, because they're gonna try to snipe, and I want to try to reduce as much damage as possible. Yeah, everyone's forgetting those, these guys right here. Whoa. Uh-oh, they're suiting and booting up right now. Oh. Oh, they're not really. Wow, a dragon now, huh? These jokers, man, inside of chat, like, you guys have been lucky all video. Yeah, those of you who don't think that you could find any type of uses for Lexi, Lexi can be used in lots of places. Wherever you don't want to take supreme blunt damage, okay, I'm talking about nuke damage. You want to reduce that. You want to reduce damage like as if you would use a Darion. That's what she would be good for, you know. She's not good for every single situation, but she's good for certain situations, and I enjoy the fact that I have her to be able to take care of those certain situations, okay? Wow, and we are getting beat down badly from these witches. Hey, stop. Stop moving. Pat Riley mode, hang on. Hang on. We're only gonna deal with this so much. This is just insane. Oh, no. Put her to sleep. Somebody do something. Let's do a heal real quick. Reduce bars. These witches were beating me down. I had to step in and do a Pat Riley. Wow, look at these. Look at the damage. It's just insane. They probably would have killed somebody if I didn't have There we go, Blooming Nightmare to get things rolling. Let's do that. No? Freeze everybody then. I gotta get everyone back to their healthy state. Once I get them back to their healthy state, then I will be happy with allowing them to go back to autoing it. Okay. I think they can auto it from there. Yeah, those witches were trying to... They're trying to get on me a little bit. I felt a little threatened there a little bit. Because, We had to deal with that situation. Alright, let them take care of these guys real quick, huh? Gulame is not gonna one-shot anyone. He can't one-shot anyone with Lexi on the team, okay? It's impossible. He's dead. He doesn't get to snipe anything because he's dead. Yeah. Yeah, so, summoning stones. Ooh. I like to go with a form of immunity to protect us from stuns. Yeah, we'll run with that. So summoning stones will be saved up. Mystical scrolls, light dark scrolls, legendary scrolls. I got like 50 something legendary scroll pieces, but I don't expect nothing better out of that other than a skill up. Okay. The legendary scrolls that you piece together, they have lied to me, okay? You guys may know people who's pulled nat 5s out of them, but I haven't had such luck. So I don't expect anything out of there except for a skill up. Uh-oh, you better watch that Rama ghost. He's about to tear off into somebody. And the type of HP they got in TOA hard mode, that's going to be quite nasty. But what I really like is how they updated the social summons. You can hold more than 1,000 points now, which is really, really nice because... And then you can also summon 10 at a time, which is also nice. And it's like, man, it's about time they did something about that. That would actually get annoying sometimes. Hey, I thought he was returning that to Cinder. You can only mitigate so much damage, buddy. All the bears that come back to life. Wow. How many net 5s are you people gonna summon in here, man? What's this all? Oh man, a Camila. Salt on my face, okay? Salt. Nothing but salt. I need her for my collection. Camila would be such an asset to me. I know, it's close to rush hour. I'm gonna have to get out of here and go fight people. I'm being forced against my will, okay? I need those red crystals. See, these two mysticals would add into a whoa, hold on, Pat Riley. Sleep. Oh man, you don't want to go to sleep, huh? I want to save it. Can we stun him? Yes. Let's get him out of here, because he's proven to be very difficult, okay? We don't like difficult. Blooming Nightmare, there we go. Let's freeze. There we go. Stun. Hey, I was meaning to do the other move. Whoa. Wow, man, now they just popped the Chimera. These people, man. I cannot sleep that guy over there for nothing. Blooming Nightmare ought to do the trick. There we go. Let's freeze him up. Oh, he survived that too, huh? Really, you just don't wanna die, huh? Wow. That's some strength there. Alright, 49. Okay, let's bring Rika for the stun, okay? And we'll bring her for the extra dots. That works. Now, Varad may have a tough time in here, but we will see. It should be all right. Should be all right. Oh, I should have brought Beretta. Yeah. Well, that's all right. Wonder how much damage each dot is chewing off now. I've missed it. It looked like 2100, I think. They're wasting abilities. And I don't like it. Ew. Whoa. Stun. Oh. There we go. Bread and butter right there. Alright, time to start saving up moves now. Start cooling everyone off real quick. Get the powerhouse out of there real quick. Buff some defenses. Thank you. Nice. Alright, let's see who's at 50. Oh! Whoa. Double G. Alright. They got the Fire Skulls next to their name, too. I'm thinking Hua. Beretta. Yeah. So we're not doing attack buff defense break. This is going to be a rough battle. Very, very, very rough. Let's try this. And if it fails, then we'll try to reroute and try to find a different game plan. You know what? I'm gonna wait. There we go. Hee hee ha ha. Ooh. Let's drop this on her. Hold on 1 second.